What's going on, guys? This is Sal with Sal's Media, here for another episode of AutoCAD Tutorials for Beginners. And in this tutorial, I'm going to teach you guys how to draw a line with an angle override. An angle override is just an angle that you can't skip out from, so it's locked onto that angle, and I'll show you guys how to do that real quick. I'm using the Mac version, but if you have Windows, you can still follow along as the functions still apply. And in this tutorial, I made this little chart with angles labeled on it so you guys can see exactly what I'm doing and you can visually learn like that. Now, to start out, I'm gonna make sure that I have my object snap turned on the bottom right, and that's going to allow me to snap to the center of this circle, which is where I want to start out. So go ahead and leave that on. I'm gonna start by drawing a line, and I'm gonna snap it to the center of that line. And now what I'm gonna do is, right where your comma key is, if you hit shift, you'll be able to use that arrow key, which is called carot. That carot key is going to be able to have you type in any number, and it's going to lock into that angle. So let's say that I want to put 45 for the angle, and you can see that it shows there, angle override. So now I can completely lock onto that angle. I can even go the other side, which is 45 degrees from the other quadrant, which is pretty cool. Now, you do learn in school that your first quadrant is this one on the top right, and zero starts on the right side. And to go up, it's 90 degrees. The other way is 180. Another 90 is 270. And 360 will also be 0 degrees. So learn that. If you haven't learned that yet, go ahead and see what it is about. There's this first quadrant, second, third, and fourth quadrant, and it goes counterclockwise. Without explaining too much from that, let's go ahead and draw another line from the center of that point. What you can also do is you can enter in that caret key and put in a negative number, like negative 45, and you can see that it snaps to the negative 45 from that 0 degree quadrant. Another thing that you can do is you can also put in a value higher than 360. Let's say that I put in 370, which is only 10 degrees higher than 360. What that's going to do is only draw it at 10 degrees higher than 360, which is the same thing as putting 10 degrees for your angle. So that is pretty interesting. If you guys like this video, go ahead and give me a big thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see some more. It was a short, easy video. It's very simple. I don't want to teach you guys too much in one video, so rewind it if you guys need to learn this again. And you guys take it easy. See you on the next one. Peace.